This is our family farm, 1,000 feet above sea level in the Durham Dales. I'm Matt Baker, and this is where I grew up with my sister, Mum Janice, and Dad Mike. After my shepherdess mum had an accident with the sheep, the farm was at a crossroads.
I knew something had to change, but I'll be perfectly honest, I didn't think it would work as well as it has.
Look at them.
Together with my son Luke.
A pretty good view.
Daughter Molly.
Eggs, anyone?
And wife Nicola.
Are my chimneys as neat as Dad's chimneys?
We're breathing new life into the farm.
You know, to start a new breed at my age, you think, oh, is it worth it? It damn well is.
I feel like a reindeer herder.
But you can't take living here for granted, as our exposed hill farm is always at risk from Mother Nature.
It's not you that needs fixing this time, it's everything on the farm.
So with a bit of help from our friends...
There's a swing, there's a drop! Oh, it was perfect!
There's a bit weird to these bees.
A bit of honey on.
You've got a bit of honey downstairs, yes.
I think it's repairable, don't you?
And alongside our animals...
Well caught.
I think they're going to be good friends.
Oh, look at Tilly.
We're getting things back on track.
The whole aim was so that you could keep doing what you love, but in an easier way.
Where there's a bad wind, there's a good wind, isn't it?
Making sure that this place is ready.
It's all about the next generation.
For whatever lies ahead.
Go! Oh!
It's absolutely massive!
This will put a smile on your face. Happy days!
Welcome to our farm in the Dales!
We've made some big decisions together as a family over the last few years. And because of all the work that we've done, the farm now runs better than ever.
Oh, look at this, beautiful.
It's easier for my parents to get around.
Pure luxury!
The new sheep breeds that we've brought from across the country are perfectly suited for life here.
Come on, boys.
And have settled in well alongside the farm's longest standing residents. Our miniature Mediterranean donkeys.
Woo!
Pygmy goats.
That's happiness in a little pygmy bundle.
And rare breed chickens. Along with a huge variety of wildlife. And not forgetting our pets. But 1,000 feet up, in an exposed valley, our farmers always faced the brunt of the winter storms. And nothing could have prepared us for the weather that we experienced this year.
It was absolutely atrocious. I went out in the truck and I could feel the truck shaking and I knew it was going to be bad. And I took some video.
Oh, it's going an absolute coolie here.
The wind, it was like a swirling wind. All the leaves were all blowing in a sort of a cone shape.
Mum and Dad were alone when the worst storm to hit the farm in living memory struck.
Just checking round you. Donkeys are obviously all right. My beautiful bay tree, my pride and joy.
Such a shame. And as I came back, we had a skip in the corner. A lot of the rubbish had blown along the track and started to pick up the rubbish, and it was literally blowing me off my feet. It's quite scary at this point. I thought to myself, nobody knows I'm here. I think I better get back to the house. I went in, Mike came rushing downstairs and he said, have you seen the field shelter? I looked out the window and I couldn't believe what I was seeing. It had smashed into the skip and the caravan where I'd literally been stood 5 or 6 minutes before.
I was shocked. I mean, when I looked out, it had lifted the field shelter off, gone up and upturned itself.
That I was upset about. All the hard work that Matthew and Nicola and the children and everybody had put into making it lovely for us and all the special times that we were looking forward to having. It had all been destroyed in moments, and I was the person that was going to have to ring Matthew up and tell him.
We rushed back to the farm to assess the damage together and make sure that everything was okay.
Is Dad there?
All right, son.
Are you coming down?
Yeah.
I think we better start here.
I'll get it, Mum.
There you go.
Oh, that's broken. Look at what's happened here.
Yeah.
Oh, I think it's cracked a bit.
Oh.
Now then, what's waiting for us down here?
It wasn't just the field shelter that was hit.
Whoa. Oh, my gosh, Matthew, look at that.
Oh, no, not my greenhouse.
Can't believe it.
Throwing the chairs about and things.
Just gone, hasn't it?
Let's have a look. This is broken, and then the front here, look, that's snapped off. I mean, that's the reality, isn't it, of living here? The main thing is, you were safe.
Nobody was hurt, and it's only a pile of wood.
Yeah.
Yeah. For all it took us, you two, all that effort.
Yeah.
You can see what's happened. It's whipped round the side. It's come across this angle. It's come down here. It's smashed the paving slabs.
From that corner?
From that angle.
The frame's bent, look.
It's lifted the bottom, prized the patio up.
Yeah. Split
flipped the whole lot, headed straight down
into
the bottom corner of the field. It's flipped the field shelter up and over the fence, which is now on its roof.
I don't want to look at it, cos that just looks like it's in as bad a shape as this.
We'll get it sorted.
I take those books.
Let's put this bench up.
Right, we can see where we are a bit now, can't we?
Yeah.
Oh, that's a lemon tree.
I'm just going to put it up the right way and then we'll take it indoors.
Yeah. Oh, it was doing so well in there as well.
Oh, my word.
I think it must have been a whirlwind, son.
With 100 acres to check, Luke and Molly are doing their bit as well.
Whoa!
Whoa! That is a big tree. I think we're going to need a new fence. That tree's just split in half and just gone.
We'll have to count them.
One, two.
With fences down and gates blown open, it's at times like these when you've got to make sure that everything's still in the right fields.
Hello. You look fine. I've got 22.
Yeah, that's the right amount.
It's a long way for these bits to be, isn't it? Some heck of a wind's come through here.
It is proper Wizard of Oz stuff.
Good job the cairns weren't out. They'd be like Toto. Oh, look.
Yeah, that my dad had them all ready to go in.
I'll save those for you, Dad. I'll take them back up for him in a bit.
Look at this. I mean, that has moved some distance, that. The donkeys can't quite believe it. They're like, how has that happened? Everything's come to have a look. Like the Herdwicks are like, how on earth are we supposed to give birth in that?
It certainly is Wizard of Oz time.
Oh, dear me, how? Because that's the back, this is the front. It's literally flipped right over. I mean, it's unbelievable how it's moved from here.
Complete somersault.
Oh, my gosh, the caravan, Matthew.
Is it mashed?
Yeah, and that corner.
Let's have a look.
Oh, my word. All this work we've done, and in just literally minutes, it's all...
I've been taking my mum and dad out for some trips around the north with the caravan, hence that's why I parked it here. Put a stop to that, isn't it? Oh, dear. It's frustrating, isn't it? Really frustrating.
Well, my curtains are all right.
Don't bend the sheets.
Mind where you're walking, Nicola.
Watch what you're doing.
That was broken, that one, anyway.
We're so lucky.
We are.
I mean, I'm standing here
on the roof.
Saying how lucky we are, but we actually are, because no animals were hurt,
you weren't
hurt.
No.
I know we're trying to make the most of it, but we are all quite shocked.
I mean, looks like the whirlwind's gone through here.
Absolute carnage.
That's knackered. My goodness me. There's a massive hole in the wall. I'm so annoyed. All the nice little things that we did. Right, what's the best way forward? Dad hasn't seen this yet, has he?
Not from this angle. And I did tell him that the caravan had shifted.
Let's keep him out of the way.
I think he's upset enough about the greenhouse without piling in about his caravan cave.
Well, we started all this thing because you had a broken leg. Now we've got a broken field shelter, a broken greenhouse and a broken caravan.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not you that needs fixing this time. It's everything on the farm.
Yeah, everything that we did the first time round. How do we move it? Because it's, like, over the top of it.
I'll ring Gordon, because we put it together.
Yeah.
Might as well take it apart together.
The new sheep breeds that we've changed over to originate from some of the most extreme parts of the UK and can withstand the harshest of conditions.
You guys all right? Not too shaken?
We have one Hampshire left and he was born blind, and so we've kept him here with the Herdwick boys.
Nanny wanted to keep it so it could live out the rest of its days on the farm with these guys. And they kind of guide him around and he kind of relies on them.
Yeah.
It must be pretty scary when there's a big storm with, like, loads of wind and things flying around everywhere and you just can't see what's happening. Right, let's go check those other fields. Any sheep behind me?
Oh, look at them.
It's time for the clean-up operation to begin. I've called our friend Gordon, and he's here with his son Henry to help us out.
Gordon, how are you?
Oh,
look at this.
Lad almighty.
I know.
Oh, dear. Well, it's unique. You'll only have one caravan looking like that.
Oh.
We'll have to push it away at the caravan to get the caravan out. Put the pallet fox under, push it with the roof. I mean, the roof's already smashed.
We can't make it much worse.
But that's what I was thinking at the time.
Henry's going to come in. He's going to strap up with the forks, lift it up, and then we'll shunt it along. Then flip it, then drag it.
Let me have a look.
Hang on. One. A bit more. One. You're clear here.
Whoa, whoa. Right, that's clear.
Clear there. Right, so we've now shifted it away from the caravan. I might just take these sheets out.
Determined to repair the field shelter, we're saving every piece that we could potentially reuse.
Rocking, it's creaking. It's like a ship. Creaking. It's like a galleon ship. It's back in position.
My word. You can see all the way in. We can feel the winds starting again, so there's another storm on its way now.
Yeah, batten down the hatches.
We'll get this turned over. Storm comes in tonight. You can come back tomorrow and we'll do it all over again.
Let's go check the chicken barn next.
Luke and Molly are discovering even more damage across the farm.
Quite a big hole.
Me and Dad put these on.
There's another piece over there. It's like Jenga. Where does the piece go?
I think these just snaps. See, there's still a screw there.
We just have to get some new panels for the top. It's definitely fixable.
Good luck, everyone.
Phase two of Operation Field Shelter will either save it or finish what the storm started.
Right, Henry, if you're ready, we are.
Right, go on, yeah.
Come on, let's make this happen.
One. Turn around.
Oh, watch
keep
out,
going.
Watch out.
Keep going.
Ah!
One.
Ah! Come on, let's make this happen.
Our friend Gordon and his son Henry have come over to help us clear up the aftermath of the storm.
One.
Ah!
And it's crunch time for our field shelter.
Well, it's the right way up.
But it's not so square anymore.
Put the hooks underneath, strap it back.
The middle?
Yeah, just pull. Keep the tension on it. That's it. Do the same around the other side and it just squares it up. It's going to be all right.
Whoa!
She's a bit rickety. Oh, God, look at that.
No, it's like...
Yeah. I think it's repairable, don't you?
I think it's a lost cause.
The wind's blowing it.
Fasten the shelter to the post to stop it from flipping again. Tag team. You do all this, don't you, to try and make everything easier and then suddenly...
Keep your feet on the ground because at the end of the day, it doesn't matter what we do, nature has always has the last here.
Sobering stuff.
We think we're in control. And we're actually not really.
One of the new sheep breeds that we changed our flock over to are Herdwicks, which we brought here from the Lake District. Joe Weir, one of the finest Herdwick farmers in the country, who helped us to start our breeding program last year, is coming to visit for the first time.
We're just getting the girls up around the gateway because Joe's on his way with a new tub.
He's bringing a new prized male sheep over to help us expand our flock and change the bloodline.
And we're just bringing the Herdwick ewes over so that when we drop the tub off, he doesn't think he's in an empty field. He's got company, and the kind of company that he's after this time of year. Joe, how are you doing?
How are you doing? All right.
Good to see you.
I'll reverse up to there.
Yeah. Good lad. Mum's bringing him over, Joe.
Oh, brilliant.
There's the flock, look.
Great. I hope you like him.
Oh, he's a beauty. How old is he?
Shealing, like last year.
Okay.
And a bigger muzzle.
Oh, he's got that, hasn't he?
And he's still got a good mouth.
Oh, my word. Mum, come and have a look at him.
Hello, lad. You love me, aren't you?
You, me, on the tub.
Hello, Joe.
Hello, nice, how are you?
Yeah. Gosh, he's not small, is he?
All right, then. Well, let's get him out.
I hope he's all right for you.
Oh, Joe.
He's definitely built for the job.
Oh, he's amazing.
Yeah, boy. There he goes.
Oh, look at that.
Oh, I love his colour.
Well, he is. He's dark, isn't he?
Oh, he's happy here already, look.
There's the new girls.
Well, he's certainly not bothered about anything else, is he? Look at him. Yeah, he fits in well.
And it's a total different line from the last one. The ewes look in fine condition.
Do they?
Yeah,
do they?
Real good.
Yeah.
The main reason we want to get our field shelter back in action is that last lambing, the Herdwicks made good use of it.
Pop that little field shelter up there just so that Mum could keep an eye on them with a bad leg and what have you looking down. And it became like this maternity ward, and they all popped in there, had their lambs, came out again.
Every one of them, it was amazing.
When one had a lamb, they all went, had a look, and then went off again and came round in this amazing kind of circle.
Oh, they are showing a bit of interest in him now.
He's just a shealing. Just he's got the rest of his life.
Will be his first time, yeah.
Beautiful sheep. To me, they remind me of clouds in the field.
He's got 20 ewes to look after, and then as soon as they come into season, bang, he'll go to work.
Leaving the latest edition of our flock to settle in, me and Mum are taking the opportunity to get Joe's expert opinion on the Herdwick lambs that were born 6 months ago. First up are the tubs.
Here's the boys in here.
Yeah, they're a good size.
Are they?
Yeah.
Good. There's a couple of cowed ones. That was a new word. to my vocabulary.
Janice, it doesn't matter if they haven't got horns.
Nobody's bothered.
No.
Come on, boys.
He's a good one, isn't he?
Yeah.
Initially, we're looking for sort of, what, like a square frame?
Yeah.
Broad at the chest area?
Yeah. And then you go on to your finer points.
You know the difference in the colour of the horn? Like a darker horn or a lighter horn?
It should be a cream white.
Right, OK. Yeah.
Real smooth. They don't want to be like a ribby, rough horn. But I wouldn't let that be your deciding factor. If it had a black horn and it was extremely good, the creamy white can come through.
There's a colour difference there with those fleeces.
A lot of that's to do with where they've been living. They're a browny, lighter colour, but we get a lot of dark lambs because they've been on the fell and they're just not as forward. I want to have a look at these gimlets.
Let's go around.
Having checked out the boys, the young females known as gimmers are next for the once-over.
Only one of them ewes threw a single, everything else was twins.
Wow, really?
Yeah.
Be the same this time, because they're a real good fettle, aren't they?
Yeah, I'm hoping so.
See, they're a little bit damp again, Matt, and they look really good, don't they? They all just look better when it's wet. They do.
I totally get that, yeah.
My favourite's the one at the front.
Why?
Just its presence. It's a good long lamb. I know it's a little bit browner, but its ears are in the right place as well. Alert.
Right. Like the leader of the pack.
Yeah. I'd be really happy with them.
Could you?
Yeah.
I'm dead chuffed. You know, to start a new breed at my age, you think, is it worth it? But actually, it's damn well.
They're laking, look.
Yeah.
They're playing, look.
Yeah.
We're ever so grateful for what you did for us.
Absolutely, eternally grateful.
I just want to better the breed, because you need generations of breeding. I did it because I want to get you interested in something.
Oh, you've definitely done that. They've been a real success. I'm really delighted with them.
There was a lot of damage to the farm caused by the recent storms. And the caravan that we renovated for my dad was one of the casualties.
Nicola and Molly and the kids, they all put it together for me, you know. A nice little den, shall we say. Beautiful view over the valley. Lovely. And then, of course, bang. It's a write-off. Write-off. Which was sad. So that was the end of that.
Keen to give him a place to make his own, we were on the search for a new, old one.
Where's that video? That doesn't look bad, does it?
No.
Not bad at all.
Oh, it looks quite neat.
Oh, look at them all in there.
This looks smaller on the video, Simon, doesn't it?
I don't think it's this one.
It's round here. Oh, I recognise it from the pictures.
Oh, it's really cute.
This is good, Dad. This is good. Hey, this was a good little find, this one.
Yeah, it's a go, isn't it?
Does the step come with it?
It can do, yeah.
We'll take it.
All right, haven't it?
Yep.
There we go.
With the new caravan back on the farm, Nicola, Luke and Molly are going to give it that personal touch and try to salvage everything they can from the old caravan.
Come on, Molly, give it some welly. Don't pull it too hard, because the whole thing will come off.
Shall
we have a go?
If they can get in it.
Wow, it's all really loose. The top's come off the chassis.
There we go.
Looks a bit dishevelled in here, doesn't it?
I told you it was bad. Molly, do you want to open that door and we'll pass some bits over? Stay in here and pass some stuff out, yeah?
Yeah, I can if you want. There you are.
I forgot how many cushions we put in there. Thank you. Right, do you want to pass me one of the throws as well? Thank you. How about the photos and stuff that have all fallen over?
Is that throw?
What about curtains, though? What Grandad said he wanted to save, though? Too bad, look. Just got a little bit wet and muddy. Ugh, feel that, look.
I'm good, thanks.
Is that everything?
Yeah, I think so. don't know whether they'll be long enough. Well, look at the one at the end. Do you want to hold them up?
Could you hold it?
Oh, they might
They're just
be
a
too
bit short.
Short.
How about this side, though? Will they go up? Well, they'd fit on there, wouldn't they?
Yeah.
Right, so we can use the curtains from there to go on these two windows, but then we'll need some more.
Do you have any fabric left?
Yes, it'll feel just like the old one, but new and improved.
As we concentrate on building up our flocks of new breeds, it's important to regularly check the general condition of all of the sheep.
Have you got everything?
Yeah.
Are we going to take some Wurmer as well?
Can do if you want.
Especially the young ones.
Go on, hurry up.
So we're running the young female Herdwicks into the pens.
Come on.
Do you want to put them through the race, do you?
Yeah, I think they'll just be a bit jumpy because this is the first real time they've been in without the mothers.
The race system means that they're a lot easier to handle.
Ooh, steady. There you go. Clever girl.
Run all the way around.
Look at that.
Through the race.
You'd never believe they'd never been in before, would you? Come on, girls. Everyone down the bus.
And it gets narrower and narrower. Yeah, sweethearts. We're just making sure that they're all in good health. These aren't in lamb. They're too young to give birth this year.
So, Wurmer and Vitamin. So, 5 mil.
I just shove my thumb in the corner of their mouth and they open up their mouth. That's it.
One for you.
These are the young females that were, well, the first lambs to be born on the farm and the future of the herd.
Next, we're moving on to foot treatment.
Yeah.
Oh, sweetheart. So, pull out any mud that's between. Not too much mud in there. Want me to do a little trim on those?
Now, the horn is quite soft compared to other sheep that I've had.
Just go around, you can see where it overlaps a little bit. Just trim it off.
She's got nice feet, actually.
Yeah, she has. This is very similar to just having your nails trimmed.
A little pedicure.
Yeah, and we'll just give a little squirt of Dettol, just between the toes, just protects them and also creates an aroma of childhood accidents.
I do have to say, I didn't have it in a squirty bottle like this.
I didn't. Do you want to have a little look at the teeth? Oh, look at those lovely teeth.
Oh, the baby teeth, look, they're just growing.
You are absolutely beautiful.
You're sweet, isn't you?
You are. Let's pop you back in the race. I'm obsessed with these Herdwicks, honestly. I picked the mums.
Yeah?
Pressure
yeah,
was
did.
On.
You did. And the dad.
Yeah. Just a little job that you keep on top of.
Those are a bit longer, aren't they?
Mm. You get up close, it's a sense of your temperament. Look at your lovely teeth. You happy with those?
Yeah. You can just see how the fleeces are turning, can't you, look? They're yeah. going from the black to the chestnut.
And then next summer, they'll get sheared, and then the new fleece that comes through will be that characteristic grey colour. There's your mum's in that top field.
That's where they're going to go now. Pasture's new.
Back to the family.
They look like they say to each other, can you smell something? Is it you or is it me?
Gentle waft of antiseptic on the breeze.
Oh, look. Oh! Ooh, we're going to look like you one day. They're like, oh, no. The juveniles are here.
Oh, look, they're all coming over now.
The older girls will teach the younger ones where the gateways are.
Yeah.
And what to do.
Next generation.
Lovely.
Nicola and Molly are busy personalising Dad's caravan by recycling the curtains from Caravan Cave Mark 1.
So we've made Grandad's curtains out of the old curtains. They're all done. But we did have some of these little ones left. We're going to make some tie backs.
Good idea.
Yeah.
And we're just going to cut round them. We don't need to measure it out or anything. We're just going to use this as a template. If it goes wrong, it doesn't matter because they're just old curtains that we're trying to make use of. Leave a little margin, about a centimetre along there, because we didn't make them for Grandad's curtains in his old caravan. I'll do one as well.
How wonky that is.
It doesn't matter. We're going to turn that like that, because we're going to fold that. And then if you leave the same amount down that side, because these bits are going to be a little turned over bit. And then try and keep it the same width all the way along. Don't worry. Then we're just going to cut the ends off a little bit, because we don't need quite this much.
Oh, that's really wonky.
Don't worry about it, Miss Drake. Granny's going to love it because you've done it.
I don't know about that.
We'll fold the ends in on each side and get some pins and then just pin the edge. Tie backs will be good for Grandad's caravan. When he's got the window open to take pictures of the birds, the curtains will be well out the way, so they won't be in the way of his photographs. That's really good. What we've got to do now is get the sewing machine and just sew that edge up. And off you go. Now, don't go too fast. I know what you're like, Speedy. It all the way to the end and stop. Brilliant, you can do mine as well. That's very fast.
Well, that's quite fast.
And stop. I'm going to take this side and fold it over to the opposite side, like that, and then pin it in place. And then there's neat edges all the way round. We can then sew it. You'll be an expert at making tie backs by the time we've done all of them. All the way, and that's it. Just sew up the ends and then we're all done. There we are. We're just going to use some Velcro because it's really simple, really easy. That's it. There we go.
Very snazzy. We have dye back.
Ta-da!
Lovely bird placing.
Two down.
Six more to go.
We better get cracking.
We've been tackling the damage caused by the storm. So far, we've managed to get the field shelter back on its feet. Unsurprisingly, it's looking a bit worse for wear. But rather than replace it with a new one, I'm keen to fix it. And the local lads who sold it to us in the first place have brought some replacement parts to try and help us out.
The lads are here to sort this mess out.
Morning.
Good morning. Lawson, how we doing, team?
I'm all right.
Right, it looks quite good from the back.
But?
Yeah, around the other side, it's not quite so good.
It lifted up, corkscrewed down the track, and then rode off that caravan.
Right, that snapped.
Yeah. These have snapped as well, Lawson, at the front. Oh, he's my mum.
Hello, Lawson.
Hiya.
What's the verdict?
Basically, we need to strip it down and then literally just start again and repair where necessary. Start from the top and work down.
There's another storm coming.
Yes, there is. Depending on the wind, see how far we can get today. Time of the essence.
If it gets too bad, we've got a caravan to go and sit in there. The roof leaks, like.
That's what happens when you land a shed on top of it.
I know. So a lot of this material we're going to reuse. I'll tell you what, though, while it was up, it was brilliant.
Is it going well? She's just come to have a look. I love the Black Welsh Mountain Sheep. They're so friendly. They're just so curious. It'll be the first time that they've lambed on the farm and I just can't wait to see what they're going to be like as mums. What's going on? Is it good?
It comes apart a lot quicker than it goes up. It's like deja vu in reverse.
For every bit of hard graft on the farm, there's another job that's a joy. For years, Mum has bred Mediterranean miniature donkeys. They thrive here at high altitude. And she's got high hopes that having spent a good few months with Red the Donkey Jack, two of them could be pregnant.
Come on. Pavlova, I knew you'd be first.
As well as Pavlova, Winifred, Luna, Augustine and Sophia are all coming in for a groom.
Very scruffy.
Maybe they could do with the sluice up. Just pop that in the corner somewhere because Pavlova will come across and think it's edible. Once we get the brushes out, they'll be like, ooh, pick me. Pick me. That's good, Molly. She's getting really calm. Look now. And Augustine, when she gets a head collar on, it usually means she's going to get her feet trimmed. That's it. She's looking at the bucket of bubbles. They're starting now just to get a little bit of the winter coat coming out. The grey-coated donkeys always seem to lose their coat first. And the last one will be Augustine, because the brown donkeys always lose their hair the last. She needs her mane cutting as well.
She needs a lot of work done.
Can you see the line that goes down her spine and across her shoulders? So you follow the line, and you see that black line appearing, look?
Yeah.
Maybe not very good scissors, those ones.
No.
Stuck like a Mohican. Watch out, Luna's going to come piling in.
Whoop. Hello.
Come here.
Do you think she'll be pregnant, since she does look a bit bigger?
I think she possibly is, and it's not because she looks fatter. In fact, I think she looks a bit slimmer. But it's her personality's changed. She's a lot quieter and a lot more hungry.
She's like eating for two.
Correct. Put her head collar on Winifred and then we can have a look at her. Come on, darling. Winifred's the eldest. There we are, look. We could give Winifred a bit of a bubble bath. Should we?
Oh, look, she's following.
Look at Pavlova just resting there on her back.
Hello.
Just having a bouffant hairdo.
Gorgeous.
Will you get those bubbles off me? That's it. Round, go on, go for it. They don't mind. A bit like a massage. So just give her a little rub. I think she quite likes that.
She's getting lower.
She's sinking. Follow the line of her neck. Perfect. Molly, what do you think?
She looks fresh.
Fresh? That's it. Give it a good rub. Got to go for it. Oh, looking good, Winnie. And Winifred and Augustine might be expecting. So hopefully in the summer, got some nice little foals to look forward to. But you never know. Nature's a funny thing. We'll just have to cross our fingers and hope for the best.
Yeah.
It's like nothing was ever here. Oh, dear. So keep that bit, yeah? First piece laid in. It's happening. Quick.
Top.
Fingers.
Bottom. Middle.
So the sides have all been rejigged, shored up. We've ended up with a scenario where if the wind gets in, obviously we've got no sheets or anything on the roof, so it can escape. Still feels like a big old sail. Believe how much has been achieved in a day.
Yeah.
Bring your sledge tomorrow.
I think snow's expected in about 2 hours.
And the wind's meant to pick up as well.
Yeah. Tomorrow's going to be a bit cheeky, I think.
Thankfully, the recent west wind only brought a sprinkling of snow.
So if you pass that one from the front,
next.
Yes, please.
And no more damage to the farm. So we're well on our way in getting the field shelter back in action.
I mean, this is the weather you want a field shelter in. The weather hasn't stopped yet. Roof goes on and we're sorted. Brilliant.
Next, please.
Ready? Woo! Skiing. We'll have a little party in there in about an hour, Lawson. We'll have a little barn dance. I'm just going to put this under the underside where there's a big gap to stop the wind from getting underneath it. This is my mother's shovel. They're brilliant, these. Robust plastic, dead light. So it means you're not actually carrying the weight of the shovel as well as the load that you've got on it. Colour-wise, it probably looks like I should be making a sandcastle as opposed to filling in the side of the foundation for the field shelter. But does the job look? The pink wheelbarrow wasn't my idea. There's one last little bit going on under here. You'd never know it was upside down a couple of days ago. Mad times, eh?
It's what Mother Nature does.
Sleeting. At least we're dry. De-sludging. We'll get the kids down with some bales in a minute. And then they can straw it up in the same way that they strawed up the last one.
Oh, yeah, they can.
Slippy, slippy.
Watch your feet.
Bit windy.
Bit squelchy.
Go on, ready?
All right.
We're looking level.
Looking good. Just let the weight hammer do the work, that's it. Let the weight do it, that's it.
Well done.
That looks very inviting.
It does, doesn't it?
Well, he's going for gold.
Yes! It makes you smile, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Very nice.
He laid down the last one. All time safe. Rewind a year. I think Molly had some straw in her hair, if I remember.
Come on, no line down.
No!
She's back.
It's brilliant, isn't it?
Yeah.
You'd never know it'd been flipped over. Thank you so much, Lawson.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you, mate, honestly. Well.
Doesn't that look amazing? Thank you so much. That's
You're welcome.
Fantastic.
It's posted down.
I didn't like to ask.
Ready for the next storm.
It's... Yeah, it's on its way, isn't it? Oh, doesn't it look great?
She's blustering. It's not even moving, look.
I'll be blown away before it will. I shall sleep easy tonight now. I'm going back in the truck.
Yeah. You can have a lie down before you go if you want.
No.
It's nice and warm in there.
But it will be now.
We're doing our best to put things back to how they were before the storm.
Deja vu, isn't it?
Yeah.
Welcome to your new home.
And with a few finishing touches, we're almost there with the first phase.
The door's going to be on the wrong side, isn't it? He's not going to have much of a view that way.
He isn't, is he? We need it round the other way.
Take it off here.
Yeah.
And then spin it round and then push it up the hill.
Good, we're not rolling yet.
Right, handbrake's off.
OK.
It's good, stop there. Good, well done. Now we'll go right.
Round.
OK.
It's all right, we're going.
Push it forwards.
Are you ready, Moles?
Welcome back to World's Strongest Man.
Here we go. Up we go. Push.
No.
One.
Two.
Cool. Legs down.
Have we got any step ladders for the...
Yes.
Ta-da!
Right, ready?
Yeah.
Get that.
What a sun. Isn't that lovely?
Oh. Yeah. I feel like Grandad, do I look like him?
What is the right answer to that?
Got the curtains.
This is why Grandad loves this caravan so much, because it's like a comfy hide. There you go, look. Oh, that's good.
That is good, isn't it?
That's a
fly
screen.
Keep the flies out. That's it. This is where you've got to keep everything crossed, Molly, that the curtains are the right size.
And there should be some little tie-backs, Molly, for these ones that we've made.
Swap that out. This one's going to be a lot safer for me, Dad. Oh, they look nice, even from this side.
They look gorgeous.
He'll be over the moon with them.
Yay!
There we go.
I'm trying to get the tie back.
Let's put the bird feeders on.
Yeah.
I feel like we're getting ready for a special visit. Well, we are, aren't we, really?
It's time to see what my dad thinks of his new and improved caravan cave.
Oh, it's back where the other one was.
Oh,
isn't that lovely? I see you've got the window. Is that so we can serve teas and that from then? Get a list out for hot dogs.
That's what I said.
There you go. Well, come and have a look.
Well, I've got my binoculars with me and I've got my books.
Have you?
Oh, lovely, isn't it? Oh, look inside, look.
New caravan, but with the old feel.
Home from home here, look.
Oh, look at the curtains.
Oh, it's lovely, isn't it? What do you think, Annie? Eh?
Oh, they're really pretty, Nicola. Do you know what? I think it's nicer than the other one.
I think it is.
Controversial. Just a bit cosier. Oh, we've got everybody in. Hello, Bob. Don't be left out.
It's like the storm never happened.
It is.
It's like the storm never happened. You're
really
dead right. It's lovely. Yeah. As when where there's a bad wind, there's a good wind, isn't there?
That's it.
And this blew in lovely. I'd be able to put my tripod here and shoot straight through there.
There's one more thing to go in the caravan, just...
Lovely.
I just got a little something to remind you of the old caravan.
Oh, isn't that lovely?
Well, there you are. Hey,
Adventures together, the Bakers.
I thought it'd be nice to remind you of the old caravan.
Well, it does remind me. We're going to have to paint the middle, aren't we?
No!
Bob seems to love it.
You've got a watchman at the door as well.
Thank you very much.
That's all right, not a problem. Thanks.
Well, we've got a key for the door and it locks from the outside, Mum.
Yes!
We'll see you later, Dad.
Bye.
Looks like Bob's staying.
Right, anyone for a gin and tonic? Dad's in.
We'll see you later.
Are we all right, Bob?
Next time.
Oh, look at the cranes!
I take a trip to Felixstowe to pick up an overseas arrival.
That's it, we're in. Oh, yes! Oh, my word!
We continue to prepare for the next storm.
There's some weight in that. Extreme pruning.
When you see what's happened across the valley, that was a danger for us.
And we welcome more new life onto the farm.
They're not old enough to run free. You cannot escape yet, little lady.